Hi guys, I'm at Snowdown Colliery in Kent. This is just one of the small outbuildings. Some sort of engine. Pump some description. I came here on my very first urban explore with my son Joshy. Watching Urbex videos and decided that I wanted to give it a go myself. I've just got to be careful guys, because there's they have security patrols here constantly, and they're normally dog units, and I've just heard a dog bark. But it's pretty quiet for a minute. Yeah, so it was back in April. It was my birthday. And I've mentioned to Josh that I wanted to start urban exploring. So he bought me a camera, he bought me a mag light torch. And he took me here. This amazing place. And it gave me the bug to come out and explore all these amazing abandoned places there are. It's just finding them and getting into them. Well, I did video our visit on my phone, but I didn't do it for an audience. I did it just as a private, personal thing, as a memory of my birthday. But since then, I've been back 3 times here to try and film this for you, because it's such an amazing sight, and each time there's been security on the main gate and I haven't been able to get in. But that is the nature of doing this. It's a good hobby. It can be disappointing sometimes, but when you do find somewhere and you get in, it's an amazing feeling. Does that get me into the building? No. It's been bricked up, guys, that part. Now the thing is here, it's a lovely place to walk around. Some of the buildings you can access, I'm sure, which we did last time. But as much as I love dogs, I don't fancy getting my arse bitten by a bloody great Alsatian. So I'm just taking my time, guys. Listening. looking. Massive buildings. To try and beat security, I've come up early in the morning in the hopes that I can get around the site before they show up. Like an old shower and toilet block, maybe. All the walls are tiled, but it's a massive place. Seems a bit extreme, but anyway, pile of bricks, but the windows are all barred along there. Okay. Up the outside. Yeah, this pit was nicknamed Dante's Inferno because it was such a hot place to work, apparently. It was the deepest pit, deepest shaft in Kent. And the working conditions were meant to be atrocious. The miners would often work naked because of the heat. Let's have a look in here, guys. It's sort of coming back to me a bit, but it's good to see it all again. Lovely old brickwork. Looks like some sort of funnel, like a big chimney. Not sure. But we also know here that a few miners died when one of the shafts flooded. And there was probably many other deaths over the years. It was a dangerous occupation. Yeah, this would have been inside at one time, I suppose. The walls are tiled, so. This bit closed permanently in 1987, over 30 years ago. And the towns and villages that were built specifically for the workers became ghost towns, really. There was no work other than the mine, or the mines, because there is more than one here, but they're all shut now and left to rot away. It gives us the chance to have a look around somewhere we wouldn't have been able to see before when it was working. That way. This is getting closer to the main gates, guys. That is the road, just the other side of that green fence. Back to this one. Lots of razor wire everywhere. Stop people getting in the buildings. Most of the entrances are either bricked up or they've got wire mesh going across. I can get in there. Make sure there's no one around. Thank you. walls. Walking wall, the way it's all mouldy, it's been burnt too. Door's pretty gone, what's left? Yeah, someone's had a fire, someone always sets fires. All the light fittings up going. In the floor. Couple of doors there. One over there. Yeah, most of the roof is gone. The plants are taking over. As nature always does. No, Victorian style rubber tiles. Well, a rat or a bird. Something just ran across the roof. I don't know if you've heard. Bird. Asbestos everywhere. Lovely old windows. Just going to take a couple of pictures, guys. Excuse me. The window. The way the paint all peels. It must be lead. Deadly poisonous, of course. Thought that was some money. Another hole here, guys. Maybe the floor's not all that stable. Some tops leading through. Yeah. started up an Instagram page, guys, and I'm putting photos up on it of the places that I go to. Right, pretty well done that one. Interesting. Hello? Some sort of bird, I guess. We're still alive. That's the one I've just been in, guys. That one can't get in. The main gate there, guys, behind me. So if I go up the back here, you can see this place is enormous. Up all the entrances or like I say, putting metal grids in front of them. Side guys, that's the main gate, the orange one down there. So at least now if security comes in, we're out of view for a minute. I'm sure there's no one here other than myself at the moment. See how overgrown it all is, guys. All propped up with acros. Keep the roof in place. Show you inside, guys. So I've just put some steps here. Let's see it from the other way. Again, the roof is mainly missing. Well, you shouldn't do it alone, I suppose. If you fall and hurt yourself, you've got no way of getting back home. So I'll probably be a bit careful. I do promise the boys I'll be careful when I come out. Split in there. It's a shame. Yeah, it's cool graffiti. something. Right. Pretty safe from there. Go to this furthest extent at the front. And then walk back along. The buildings at the front of the site, just by the main road here. See how it goes. In there, barred up again. An explorer lost his shoe. Just an old outbuilding. Another couple of pictures, guys. Past the front gate. Now taking a few snaps again, guys. Sorry, keep interrupting the video. But anyway, I think we've seen what we can see today. It's been a nice little trip out for me to finally be able to get in. Maybe where some of the workers would have lived. Just have a look up here, guys, a sec. Stinks, guys. I'm gonna stop the video there. Oh, sliding back down. I'm way up with her. It'd be a good idea to go in there. Or whether I can get in there. Right, I'll catch you later, guys. There might be a part two to this. See you later.